If you're like me, you haven't spent a lot of time celebrating fungus. But in one town in our region, there's a fungus with a following.
Mushrooms can appear as if by magic, but what you see popping up on your lawn is just the fruiting body. This fruit doesn't come from a tree. Instead, it comes from an underground network of fungus called mycelium, and these fungal networks can be huge. This is Crystal Falls, a friendly, quaint community in Michigan's Upper Peninsula. In 1992, the residents of Crystal Falls found out they had a remarkable, gigantic, and nearly invisible neighbor after scientist and forest pathologist Johan Brun discovered one of the largest fungal networks on the planet.
Here's an example of a very poisonous mushroom.
We estimated that the large individual occupied about 38 acres of the forest floor. I think we called it something like 100 tons, and was probably several thousand years old.
Johan is a key figure in a documentary about the discovery, aptly titled The Humongous Fungus Among Us. It was created by filmmaker and Crystal Falls native Tim Wormanen, who works in video post-production in Chicago.
I used to tell people that I'd work with in post-production that, you know, I grew up in this small town next to this really giant mushroom, and people said, like, what are you talking about? And I always, like, questioned, like, what am I talking about? I feel like people in the community maybe didn't know a ton about it, and so, you know, I thought maybe we could interview the original scientists who discovered this thing, like, best to go to the source.
Tim began working on the project in 2013, and in 2021, it premiered at the Crystal Theater in downtown Crystal Falls.
There's something lurking in the woods. Literally hundreds of newspapers, magazines, even the television networks are covering the humongous fungus, and it's conjuring up all sorts of images.
When the fungus was discovered and when the documentary was shot, Jeff Sergenin co-owned the Crystal Falls Ben Franklin Variety Store.
And at the time, everyone was thinking it was an April Fool's joke because it just sounded so bizarre to most people here.
Bizarre or not, when Jeff heard fungus, he saw an opportunity.
The Fungus Fest starts today.
He helped to organize a number of community events and parties, all centered on the humongous fungus discovery. Jeff and his wife even came up with humongous fungus t-shirts.
Played with our words a little bit and changed the spelling of humongous a little bit to go along with the fungus.
This is the current one. It's become definitely a part of Crystal Falls history.
If I had to guess, in the past 30 years at the Ben Franklin store, we sold roughly 20,000 humongous fungus t-shirts.
The community fell in love with the humongous fungus, and in 1992 began celebrating it with an annual Crystal Falls Fungus Festival. Since then, the fungus and the festival have become part of the town's identity. The mushroom also made a splash in the media and in the scientific community.
It was one of these bizarre items that was in the paper today. You may have read about this. The scientists have found the world's largest living organism in Michigan. Did you read it? It's a 100-ton mushroom. True, a fungus spread over 30 acres. And the most amazing thing that they didn't tell you, it's sitting on top of a 500-acre porterhouse steak.
Myron Smith was a graduate student when the fungus was discovered and studied it with Johan Brun and scientist Jim Anderson.
Jim worked on the genetics of our malaria. Jim had just taken on a new graduate student, Myron Smith. We were a tremendously compatible team of researchers as well as friends.
When that paper in 92 came out, there was a lot of press interest and there was a lot of appreciation for the publicity that was gained about fungi in general, because fungi are super interesting and very important and rather mysterious.
If the environment stresses living trees, our malaria is going to take advantage of that stress and kill them.
In the natural ecosystem, they're really fulfilling a need. And the other role that this fungus has in the forest ecosystem is that it's really important for recycling nutrients.
There are a lot of lessons to be learned from how these organisms have lived for thousands of years in the same spot. Obviously, they're managing their resources efficiently and sustainably.
Is there a chance that the humongous fungus will outlive us all?
Well, it's almost certainty.
It's guaranteed.
Yeah, almost. Yeah. Maybe not guaranteed.
I think so.
Pretty close.
I think it's a
pretty
guarantee.
Close. Yeah.
It's guaranteed, I think.
Yeah.
Over the years, Johan, Myron, and Jim learned that the fungus was much larger and much older than they originally thought.
You've been studying this individual for decades now. Give us an idea how large and how old.
Now we know that it's at least 2,500 years old. It weighs about 440 tons, and it occupies an area of almost 200 acres.
Wow, that's big.
They also discovered the fungus's genes are remarkably stable. An organism so large and old might be prone to a lot of mutation, but Myron says that's not the case.
We're not sure how it maintains that stability, but you know, it's a real lesson somehow in how to protect and maintain your genome. And we can contrast that, you know, for example, to cancer in humans, where the genome very quickly takes on new mutations. This organism has fewer mutations from one end to the other than we do as humans, from our fingertip to our toes.
Tim says the mushroom and his film about it are a testament to what sets his hometown apart. But we won't know for
a couple of months. And I think it's just really, it's something that we can celebrate, being about, you know, the wonders of nature in a small community. And I think most importantly, it was one way, like one line in the film talks about discoverability and what makes your community unique. And it's something that the science has drawn people in to the community and drawn people together to talk about the wonders of nature.
In many ways, as the mycelium is the connective tissue of this Great Lakes ecosystem, it's also become a source of unity for the town of Crystal Falls.
The local people just get a nice smile when you even bring up the word humongous fungus. It's just been a real happy thing for our community, and it just kind of puts us on the map in a different way, a way that is exciting and fun for people.
But in case you're planning your trip to Crystal Falls to find the mega mushroom.
And I've been asked this many times because I seem to be the person that answers most of the questions up here. We always tell them that it's something you can't see. It's something that you really don't need to go to. And then, of course, then they ask me, is it real? Or did you guys just make all this up to get a little publicity? And it's like, no, but we really want to protect the forest and the area where the mushroom is. So we do discourage people from going into that area.
But don't worry, there are lots of mushroom-related activities on offer in Crystal Falls. So if you need a fungal fix, consider checking out the town's annual Humongous Fungus Festival. It's open to the public and takes place every summer.
At Great Lakes Now, we aim to cover the Great Lakes region and the people who live here, like you. Please follow us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and sign up for our newsletter at greatlakesnow.org.